Now, every day is like a holiday to me, and I even wrote a song about that, with the use of that lyric. Now, continuing at the last paragraph from the first video, we're at the first paragraph of page 2. At the end, it talks about a very complicated and messy risk and reward profile. Now, I'll replace the word complicated and messy with proper words for the sake of keeping the public from rioting. When I say keeping the public from rioting, I'm also saying to keep the public from playing with 220 volts of electricity over in the rushing rapids of thought. So all's that changing the wording on words that the potential princes of peace like to use. That they've been trained to use, that they're used to using. Most of your potential princes of peace use words that are unhealthy. And that's just a reality that we have to look at. But in a way, it's not really unhealthy because that's just where they're at. So, even though the words that they use can lead down the rabbit hole of the legal world. So there we have it. It's the legal world. For the sake of the reality of the legal world, we do realize that the legal world is just a phase that we're going through to help us get moved into the lawful world. And if there's anything you'll notice about the legal world, it's full of words stacked on words, stacked on words, stacked on words, which is a good thing now. We don't want to lose our picture of the goodness that Prison Planet was, why it was brought to us. All these rules and regulations, statutes and codes, local court rules, even at up to the international level of all the legal dictionaries that there are on the planet. These legal dictionaries are just a stepping stone. They are not the ultimate in fulfillment of the human life. Just a stepping stone. So for those that are using legal terminology to live their lives off of, then we must, those of us who are lawful, it's a much more advantageous to let them use the legal language that they are comfortable speaking, but to also to be ready if those participating in the legal world would like help, if they have questions, or if we sense that there is a comfortable spot to share lawful knowledge with someone who is participating in legal knowledge.
Not Tiny. Tiny says, yeah.
So, now, I wanted to bring up complicated and messy here in the first sentence of page 2 at the end of the paragraph. I wanted to bring that up because it precedes the phrase risk and reward profile. Now, a risk and reward profile is just a another way, lawful way of saying to die to the ego, because it's a risk when you make change happen in your life, because you're venturing into new territory and it's a little bit nervous, and you're in your legal mind, you think that you're going to lose things, and that's where the word risk applies. In all actuality, when you go through the legal process and you follow it through and you eventually arrive to where you can feel a sense of well-being, all of that risk, which is just another word for navigating the rapids of thought, the rushing rivers of thought, navigating those rivers successfully. Navigating the rushing rivers of thought successfully. And it can be done. You can navigate the rushing rivers of thought successfully. Like I said, all you have to do is just say to yourself, well, these thoughts that I'm encountering are just thoughts that make me uncomfortable, so therefore I am going to create with my imagination a comfortable remedy, the way that I would like things to turn out comfortably for the benefit of myself. And when you do this, this is what you call it accounting. Because now you prevent yourself from becoming injured by becoming your own physician and healing yourself. Not only healing yourself, but also you're performing what's called preventative maintenance. Preventative maintenance is is just another word for being able to see with your third eye and a balance of your inner and outer eye, being able to see potential harm and injury down the road. For example, if you're driving down the street and you notice that there's a large branch that's partially broken and it's just hanging over the street. If things are clear on the other side of the street, you drive around the branch instead of under the branch. Until such a time as you've developed your faith strong enough that you can drive right under the branch, because you're holding the branch up with your thoughts. And in fact, your thoughts are so powerful that you can instantaneously morph all situations with the power of your mind. So all you have to do as you're driving under that branch is just envision that branch to reconnect itself and to strengthen itself instantaneously. And it will lift and put new bark on and wood and strengthen instantaneously. This is the potential power of the mind that we are entering into in this day and age that we live in with this mind shift. That's what we call the third phase, which is a phase of self-regulation in the ways of peace, safety, and responsibility. Creating our own realities, and eventually we'll each get our own planet. But there is still a path to walk to get there. Okay, so the next, so I just describe risk and reward. Risk is a somewhat okay word, legal word to use. It's kind of like a transitional word. It's not like we use the word chaos. If we were to say the word chaos and reward, that is a word that the public, for the most part, sees as a world of a mess. So, but just realize, even in your quest of improving yourself, if you use a word that is legal, and you know, you just needed to find a word to use at the time, so you just settled for that word. Remember that it's still a good word if you attach your intention to that word, because it's the intention, for the most part, that brings about the manifestation of our desires. The only reason why we want to choose to use more healthier words is for the sake of the public. Because when they read the words, or they hear the words spoken from our voices, they can easily go down the road of their own thoughts and put their own intentions on those thoughts. For instance, if they see the word messy risk, they think to themselves, impossible situation, chaos, death, destruction, injury. And so even though you're one man who has spoken a legal word and you've put your intention on it, if you by yourself are not yet strong enough to fulfill that intention, then all the other people who heard your words, your legal words, all the other people, for the most part, might put a different intention, one that is injurious and harmful, on the situation. And it's possible that they could outweigh the intentions of the many, even though they've put their intentions on it without understanding. It is possible for all those intentions to bring about its desire, and it could overpower your single intention. That's just another way of saying one man against a million. One intention against a million intentions. So, just keep in mind that one man's intention can overpower a million intentions. One man's intention can overpower 7 billion intentions. But the more that men enter into agreeing with that one man's intentions, by way of the knowledge, ancient knowledge of the Illuminati and Freemasons, then the stronger that intention of health and prosperity will manifest. And I just like to say and add to that that there are many people who hold the ancient knowledge of the Illuminati and the Freemasons. And in fact, there has been a shift or a tipping point on the earth where our lawful intention has passed 51%, and we are now on the road to the majority, or we are the majority now, and therefore that's why these manifestations of world improvements are here on the scene today. So let me read paragraph number 2 now of page 2. It's the paragraph that has the bold words below it that says the plan of the book. There is one little paragraph right atop of it, and it starts off like this. The book attempts to make sense of the world we live in and to provide a few clues as to where we might be headed. In the following pages, we try to explain what's going on, a difficult task since it is very hard to boil down the global economy into 101 snapshots. Nonetheless, we try. Now, just use the law of the universe, the laws of the universe, to that sentence, and basically it's a legal sentence. Because for the most part, most your government writers are used to using legal codes. And but if we translate these legal codes here into lawful words, then it's easy to understand the simplicity of the world that we live in. Because this sentence talks about the difficult task that we're facing. And like I said, if you put intention into that legal phrase called difficult task, it's just the same as using the phrase messy risk. When at its heart, we are the authority of all manifestations, all outcomes, and all interpretations of everything going on in the planet. And so if we tell ourselves that everything's easy, it will be. We will manifest ease in our lives. If we learn to look at the potential in everything, in every situation, if we learn to focus and keep our eyes focused on the potential of everyone, of every situation, then that is a consistent desire that we set before our eyes and our ears. And we can even tape it up to the walls and put it in the front of our eyes, put it on t-shirts, make hats and bumper stickers, paint jobs, tattoos, all the nine yards. If we just look at everything in its potential and we describe everything with potential language, which is the lawful language, which is the language of life. If we just look at it that way, then we see that all legal systems are just contrast for us to set that new desire before our eyes of potential. Not only potential, but it is potential to be manifested. And it will manifest. we constantly remind ourselves of that manifestation and expect that manifestation of potentiality to manifest and to be supported with the signs of Mother Nature. When we see the tree bend, we know the wind's blowing, is a famous statement by Winston Shrout, who has been the private international military top educational representative for distributing private maritime law to the people. When we enter into universal law, then legal codes will naturally diminish to the point that all of us on the planet are operating at the full capacity of our potential, guided by the higher laws of the universe. So we'll stop right there, and I'll decide whether or not I want to continue with this. But I think I've said enough that for anyone else continuing reading what's going on in here, that they could simply apply the principles that I've revealed in these two videos, and we will see a speedy recovery of our planet under law. Like I said, I will decide if I get the motivation to read on and to translate this legal document into a lawful document. But like I said, I've probably given you enough that you can do it yourself. Okay.